All right, so let me share 7 tips with you that I wish I would have known when I got started with IntegraMAT. Tip number 1, rename the modules inside your scenarios for like a better overview. This is super easy to do. You just go over to your scenario, you right click the module, and then here you click rename, and then you could give it a bit more descriptive description of what that module is doing. So for example here, by default, it always says like, hey, Google Sheets, and here, for example, Active Campaign. And then maybe here I'm checking, for example, if there's any new members that I added to a Google Sheet. So then I would just say, check for new members. And then this one is like creating or updating contact. It also says it here, but what I like to do then is I say rename, and then I just say create new contact. So just a little bit of a better overview. With these small modules, maybe it doesn't matter so much. But for example, if you have a bigger scenario like this, then over here you see that I renamed every single module so that if I'm not looking at this for a few months, I still exactly know what this scenario is doing. Tip number 2, add notes to your scenarios. And I think this is especially handy if you create maybe some scenarios that are a bit like set and forget. And then maybe if you want to look at it at a later moment in time, then you quickly can look at the notes and then you know exactly what you have been doing. So to add a note, super easy. You just go over here, select any module you want. For example, I want to add a note to, let's say, this mix panel module. I right click it and then here I say add a note. And then I can just say blah, de, blah, de, blah. Right, and then it will just show up over here. And if I want, maybe I also want to add a note over here. This is blah, blah, right? And then you see that this really easily shows up. You go down here, you click notes, and then you can basically explain the scenario a little bit to yourself. Or maybe if you work in a team, you can also use it to explain something to others. And another thing I like to do, so for example, sometimes you use like webhooks, and then you could add a note and you can here add like a link inside your notes where you are triggering that webhook. So for example, I'm doing that with automations inside ActiveCampaign, then I link to that automation. And then whenever I'm here, I'm like, oh, okay, this webhook module, and which automation is this triggered? Then I go to my notes and then boom, I see, ah, this is where I trigger that webhook. Tip number 3, use hotkeys to quickly copy and paste modules in the same scenario or even to another scenario. So to do that, super easy. You just press shift, then you see that you get this like selection thing. Then you select the modules that you want to select. For example, I want to select these 4. And then depending whether or not you're on Windows or on Mac, you can just press Command C or Control C. So I'm pressing Command C because I'm on Mac. And then to paste it, I just press Command V. So if you're on Windows, Control V, right? So then I do that. And then you see that real easy, I got these and then maybe I can move them somewhere else or do something else. And this also works between scenarios. So I can also go to this scenario that I showed you earlier, and then I can just quickly paste this in here. So I think this is really super duper handy, can save you quite a lot of time, but you just have to know that that is possible. Tip number 4, learn to use functions. I think functions inside IntegraMAT are really super duper handy, and it's very beneficial to learn how to use those right from when you get started with IntegraMAT. So inside your scenario, just go to any module, for example, this one, and then what you can do is you can modify these variables. So these variables, right, are like from the previous module, and then I can modify these variables to something else. So you, for example, over here have general functions, you have math functions, you have text functions, and you have date functions. So what I could do in this example, because over here I have a Google Sheet that is checking if I have any new members that are on that sheet, and then I automatically want to add these people to my email service provider, which in this case is ActiveCampaign. So then what I might want to do is that I want to capitalize the first letter of their name and make everything else lowercase, so that if they wrote their first name in capitals, that I'm not saying like, hey, John in capitals, but that only the first letter is capitalized and everything else is lowercase. So to do that, I just go over to the text and binary functions. Here I go to start case, and then you also see this example over here with hello world. And you see that only the first letter of every word is capitalized and everything else is lowercase. So I just click here, start case, I paste my first name variable over here. I click OK. And then now when a contact is created, only the first letter of their name is capitalized and everything else is lowercase. But you can also do other things with functions. So for example, you have date and time functions, and then you can change maybe the format of that date and time to something else. Also super duper handy. So I have a whole playlist over here with tutorials about that that you can check out if you want to learn how these functions work. Tip number five, and I think this is another handy feature that you really should learn when you want to use Integromat to the fullest extent possible, and those are HTTP modules and webhook modules. And I have to admit, they're a little bit more taggy, but I also have some tutorials about those, so be sure to check those out. But in short, this is how they work. So what you can do with these, so for example, with the HTTP module, this is a HTTP module, you can integrate tools with Integromat that otherwise maybe do not have a native module inside Integromat yet. So this is really handy if you have a tool that is not in Integromat yet, but you really want to integrate it. Then if that tool has an API, then you can use a HTTP module to make that connection. So for example, here you see that I connect with Daymio. Daymio is webinar software. In the meanwhile, they also have native modules, but before they did not have it. So I needed to use their API to make this connection with Integromat. So I just hit edit the HTTP module inside my scenario. And then here I have their API URL. And then over here in the query string, in this case, I had to authenticate with my API key and my API secret. And in this case, I was using that to list all the webinars that were available. And with webhooks, webhooks are handy basically for the other way around to get data from a tool. So here, for example, I have this webhook URL. So this is a URL that I used for ManyChat. So ManyChat is like a Facebook Messenger bot software or chat bot software. And then from that tool, I could send data to this webhook. So I think webhooks and HTTP modules are really handy to learn about in case you want to connect something to Integromat that doesn't have a native module yet. Tip number six, use routers, and specifically like kind of like if else routers. So in if else, you basically ask a question and then is that thing true or false? And then if it's true, follow this path. If it's false, follow that path. And you can also do something like that inside Integromat, which I think is really handy for lots of different things. So here I have a simple example. So for example, here we have Calendly. Calendly is like a scheduling software that people can use to pick a spot inside your calendar, and then they can schedule a call. And then, for example, what I wanted to do is I wanted to send a different confirmation email depending on whether if it's a coaching call or another call. And then to do that, what I can do is I have this over here. So whenever a new event is scheduled, we go into our router. And I think routers in general are also really handy because they allow you to split your scenario in multiple routes. But then what you can do this way is you can set a condition here inside this filter. So inside this filter, I said, okay, the condition here is the Calendly event name contains coaching. If that's true, then it will follow this path. And then what I did with this like kind of like if else logic is I said, okay, if that is not true, I want to basically follow another path because I still want to send a confirmation email to that person. Like, hey, thanks for scheduling a call with me. So to do that, you go over here and instead of setting a condition to create a filter, you click this over here and you say, this is the fallback route. So this will be used in case where a bundle cannot continue on from the router via any other route. Now and then here, for more information, check this help article over here. So if this is a match, it will continue over here, and then it's not going to continue over here because the bundle could continue through this path. So if the name of that event does not contain coaching, then it cannot continue over there, and then it's going to continue through the fallback path. So I think this is super duper handy. I use this in quite a lot of scenarios, so I quickly wanted to share this tip as well. Tip number seven, take a look at all the example scenarios that are out there so that you maybe also get some inspiration of what is possible with a tool like Integromat. Because I think that's maybe something that people also struggle with. Like maybe you already start to get to know how Integromat works, but you don't really know what you could automate or integrate inside your business. So what you could do is inside Integromat, you can go over to their template library. So over here on this page, you see lots of ideas. And if you want to look for any tool specific examples, then you can also just go over, for example, to any of these modules. You can also type in here, but for example, I'm using ActiveCampaign. Then I click this, and then I see all these examples for ActiveCampaign, and I really like this. Another thing you could do is you can go over to the IntegraMod blog, and then you see here that they have 50 different scenarios that you could use to automate things, which I think is super cool. And I also created another video that you can check out over here with my 7 favorite scenarios. So then I'll just give you also some ideas of things that I like to do myself. So then I'm curious, which of these tips did you like most? Make sure to post that in the comments below. And if you have any tips of your own, feel free to share those as well.